So what's up, wrestling community? How are you doing? Because Survivor Series is coming up this month, I've decided to do predictions for its card. Okay, we already have some matches announced, only three, but I'm going to predict the other matches that are going to be, I think are going to be on the card. Probably they won't be like I think them, but who knows. So I'm going to start off with the women's match between Becky Lynch, Shayna Baszler and Bayley. You know, can this match change? Because all the time we have some changes before Survivor Series, you know, championship changing hands, but this time I don't think so. Yeah, it's card predictions, but I'm going to say that at this moment I think Becky Lynch is going to win the match. So yeah, that's it. The other match that is already announced, it's going to be the tag team champions match between SmackDown's Revival, Raw's Viking Raiders and NXT's Undisputed Era. You know, Kyle O'Reilly and Bobby Fish. But I think this match is going to suffer some changes because I think the Revival is going to drop the championships to the New Day this edition of SmackDown this Friday, and yeah, this match could be great in both ways with both Revival and the New Day, either Revival or the New Day, but I think New Day is going to be here and Revival is going to be somewhere else. And now it's time for the third and the last actual announced match, already announced. I'm talking about Rey Mysterio versus Brock Lesnar. Why they've decided to do this on Survivor Series? We all talked that Brock Lesnar is going to face Adam Cole and The Fiend Bray Wyatt in an All Champions match, but no, he had to defend the championship against Rey Mysterio. You know, it is what it is. The match is going to be great, I think, because every single time when Lesnar faces a smaller opponent, like, you know, Reyes, I'm talking about when he faced Finn Balor or Daniel Bryan or even AJ Styles, all of those matches were great, and yeah, this scenario works, you know, Brock Lesnar against a smaller opponent, so I think the match is going to be great. Of course, Brock is going to win, and this is the last match that I'm going to predict the winner as well. The other matches are only going to be how I think the card will look like, and I will do in the future another video predicting the winners. First match that hasn't been announced yet, it's the mid-card championship champions. I'm talking about the United States champion from Raw, AJ Styles, the Intercontinental champion from SmackDown, Nakamura, and the NXT North American champion, Roderick Strong. And yeah, this match can suffer some changes, maybe like Daniel Bryan winning the Intercontinental Championship. But no, I think this is going to stay like that. You know, this match, it has been rumored a lot, and I think it's going to happen, this Survivor Series. Of course, it's going to be an unbelievable matchup because of all three competitors, you know. And yeah. Yeah, and after that, it's time for the traditional Survivor Series match for the tag teams. And yeah, basically all tag teams on each brand are going to be in this match, you know, who are not the champions, of course. Yeah, I'm predicting for all the captains to be either the Street Profits or... I'm predicting Gallows and Anderson to be the team captains because, you know, they are the best tag team in the world. They've just won this tournament. And it makes more sense, in my opinion, for the tag team captains to be heels. I don't know why, but it makes to me. So yeah, the tag team captains are going to be Luke Gallows and Karl Anderson. Yeah, so for the SmackDown side, as I said, I think Revival are going to drop the championships to the New Day, and I think they are going to be in this match the captains. So the captains for Team SmackDown are going to be the Revival. And as about NXT, I think Tyler Breeze and Fandango are going to be the tag team champions. Of course, it's going to be an unbelievable matchup and a very chaotic one, you know, because you have all these competitors. I only thing that I hope is that it's not going to be, you know, rushed like it was every single time, you know, because, you know, like elimination. I don't want that. I think they should give them a little bit more time than they did before. And another traditional Survivor Series matchup is going to be women's Survivor Series match. I think Raw's captain is obviously going to be Charlotte Flair, because, you know, she's not the women's champion. Of course she's going to be in this tag team and the tag team captain. And she's going to pick her team by maybe some qualifying matches, or I don't know, maybe. Yeah, and for the SmackDown, I think the captain is going to be Sasha Banks. She is going to pick, I think, maybe her team, not by qualifying matches. She is going to pick whoever she wants or something like that. And the NXT side, I think the captain for them is going to be Rhea Ripley, you know, because excepting Shayna Baszler, she looks like the most legit and strong woman on the roster. So I think she's going to be the captain. And the actual Survivor Series traditional match, the men's match, is going to take place as well, of course. It is, I predict that Raw's team will consist of Ricochet, Drew McIntyre, Seth Rollins, Randy Orton and Kevin Owens. I think the captain is either Randy, but no, this time I think Seth is going to be the captain, because, you know, he's not the Universal Champion, and he needs, exactly like with Charlotte, he needs a, you know, a big spot as well. And I think he's going to be the tag team captain and lead his team. I don't know if to victory or something else, I don't know. Yeah, and for the SmackDown, I think the team will be Baron Corbin, Roman Reigns, Daniel Bryan, Braun Strowman and Ali. Again, normally I would say, of course, Roman is going to be the captain, but this time I don't think he's going to be the captain, because, you know, he just was in Saudi Arabia at the Crown Jewel. And this time I think Daniel Bryan is going to be the tag team captain. Yeah, and for the NXT side of things, I think the members are going to be Keith Lee, Keith Lee, Matt Riddle, Finn Balor, Johnny Gargano, Tommaso. The team members are going to be, NXT's team members are going to be Keith Lee, Matt Riddle, Finn Balor, Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa. The captain here, I think, is going to be Finn Balor. He may bring up the demon, maybe, who knows. And it's going to be, of course, an unbelievable matchup. What I don't like, though, I don't want any of these matches to be, you know, like these traditional three-corner tag team matches, you know, like they can get in by tagging even the Nemesis or something like that, the opponent. I don't like that. I mean, I would like it to be only a triple threat match, you know, with everybody having four members to tag, not tagging from the adversaries or something. I don't like that. Yeah, I think this match is going to be as well very chaotic, and this is probably going to be the longest match of the night. And I can wait to see how it turns out to be. And the actual main event of the night, I think, is going to be Bray Wyatt, the Fiend Bray Wyatt, the Universal Champion from SmackDown, against Adam Cole, the NXT's World Champion. As I said before, the match would have been much better if it was a triple threat match, you know, with Brock Lesnar added to it. But it is what it is. The match is going to be great, probably, as well. It's going to be like, you know, like Seth used to fight the Fiend, you know. Adam Cole is going to hit him with a lot of his finishers and all of his moveset. And the Fiend is still going to get up. I think this match also is going to be like the decisive match, you know, because before this match, Roy is going to have only one or at the best two wins, maybe I think one actually. And SmackDown and NXT are going to be tied up, you know, it's going to be like 3-on-3 or something like that. And this match is going to decide who wins, you know, SmackDown or NXT. And I think SmackDown is going to win because Bray Wyatt is going to beat Adam Cole. And yeah, that's it. Let me know how you think the Survivor Series card is going to look like. Of course, I'm going to do a prediction for every match and every match winner. But I will do that when the actual card is available, you know? And until then, bye.